Welcome to WebStarburst. Should you console log in React.js? Should you console log in JSX in React.js? Where to console log in React.js? Okay, you can console log in React.js, but where is it appropriate to do it in component? Console log is one of the most useful functions that allows us to debug, create proof of concepts, and add functionality to a web app. React.js does not restrict the use of console log method, but because of its special JSX syntax. This is JSX. There are some good practices that should be followed. You can console log before return in handle click or handle whatever, in componentDidMount and in useEffect hook. You can also console log in JSX. I will show you how. In JSX, JSX allows us to write HTML in React. It allows us to write HTML elements in JavaScript and place them in DOM without createElement or appendChild methods. But JSX is not vanilla JavaScript, nor it is HTML. It is syntax extension of JavaScript that converts HTML tags into React elements. It makes code easier to read and understand, and JSX gets compiled into vanilla JavaScript. In JSX, simple console log statement written in the div tag does not work. It will just render the whole thing in the browser. For example, this console log will not work. It will be printed as is here. Instead, write expressions inside curly braces in JSX in React.js. The expression can be React variable, a property, or any other valid JavaScript statement. JSX will execute the expression and return the result. Here is how. Use curly braces. Save. And now we have got console log in JSX. You can use console log above return statement here. For example, this one, console log before return statement. Save, console log before return statement, console log in JSX. And here, it does not need curly braces. In handle click, let's say we've got a button and its on click event. We've got an event handler that is handle click. Before return, we will use handle click, get the event, and let's console log this event, click event. Save, refresh. Now at click of this button, we've got this event logged in console. Click, click, click. At each click, this event is being logged. This is a good way to capture an event and see if you are getting proper value or result. Now every time we click at the button, it will log the event to console. If you want to use console log only once, you can use lifecycle methods in React class components like componentDidMount. Here's how. Create a component in src folder, name it comp2.jsx, import component from React, class comp2 extends this component, constructor props, component did mount, then we've got render and return. In component did mount, we have this console log. In return, let's use an input. On change, get the event and set the state to event target value. So here, super props, and this is our state. Right now, input is empty. We will export this component. Then we will import this component in our app.js and we'll use it here. Components comp2, input state is empty, 1, 2, 3, state changed, 4, 5, 6, state changed, but this console log that is inside componentDidMount logged only once. Even when we are changing the state, this statement ran only once. So you can use console log in componentDidMount. Similarly, for function components, we can console log in useEffect hook. It will also log only once and won't log each time component re-renders unless we want it to. So here is a function component. comp3.jsx, import use state use effect from React, function component name, export the component. This is our state, input 2, set input use state. We've got our return statement. Inside we've got input. Set input, eTarget value, this set input. And here is our use effect. Inside use effect, we have used console log. Log only once from use state hook. Now let's import this component and then use this component. Save, console log before return statement, console log in JSX, log only once from componentDidMount, log only once from useState hook. Now state has been changed. For component 2 and for component 3, this is component 3, this is component 2. But this console log was fired only once. We can change that. If we want to log it each time when state changes, we can do so. So this state has been changed. We can use the state here in use effect here as a dependency. When this variable will be changed, use effect will be fired again and console log will run again. So now refresh, 1, 2, 3. Now as I am changing value for this input field, use effect is running again and firing this console log each time when this state changes. Save, 1, and this is the value, 2, 3, 4. Now each time state changes, console log is being fired. We can also create a separate component in React.js to just use console log. Pass logged value or string as a child and render the parent console log component that is receiving the logged information. For example, create a new component logger.jsx. Const WSP console log. This is the information that's being received that we are printing in console log. Return false. And then we just exported this WSP console log. Save. Let's import WSP console log from logger.jsx. Save. And then use it here. This is our logger. And this is our information that we want to pass. This is log one. Log two. Log three. And here it is. This is log one, log two, log three. Refresh. Log one, log two, log three. Now we can log anything by using this separate component in JSX. It will receive logged value as a child and console log it. There are many ways you can use console log in React.js app. We showed you 6 ways to console log in React.js. But once you debug your app, make sure you delete all occurrences of console log before exiting the development environment. Console log statements add nothing to the production mode, so they should be removed at the end. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.